He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Okay, let's take a look at a problem regarding the density of a gas. The question is very simple. It simply asks, calculate the density of ammonia at 30 degrees Celsius and 5 atmospheres. So you may want to review some information on ideal gases. I have several tutorials on this concept if you need some review, and when you're ready, give it a try. So we have a very handy equation that relates all of these variables associated with a gas, and that is the ideal gas law, PV equals nRT. Now, the thing is that we want to talk about density. Density is not present in this equation, but we do have moles, and moles is going to correlate with density because from moles we can be talking about mass, and from mass and volume we can be talking about density. And so the relationship we want to utilize here is that the molar mass equals mass over moles, right? It's a grams per mole value. So molar mass equals the grams of the gas over the moles of the gas. That will be the molar mass. Therefore, if we rearrange, we can solve for moles and say that moles is equal to grams over molar mass. So, because that is the case, let's go ahead and plug that in for n. So instead of n, we're going to rewrite this, but we're going to say PV equals little m over big M times RT. So now we've gotten rid of moles and we have mass and volume in there. That's going to be important because, as we said, density is mass per volume. So that means we should be able to rearrange this equation in order to get mass and volume together. So let's multiply both sides by big M and divide both sides by V, and that is going to give us PM equals little m over V times RT. Now this is very important because we have put m over V right here where we want it, and that means we can change that to density because mass over volume is density. And so now we have density in our equation and we can solve for it. So D is going to be equal to PM over RT. Now we just plug in what we know. For pressure, we are given 5 atmospheres. For molar mass, that's going to be the molar mass of ammonia, which is 17, because nitrogen has a mass of 14 and each hydrogen is 1, so that's 17 grams per mole. Then we have the gas constant, which, as always in this context, is going to be 0.0821 liters atmospheres per mole Kelvin. And then the temperature is given to us, but remember, we always need to convert from Celsius to Kelvin. That is our absolute temperature scale. So we're going to add 273, and that gives us 303 Kelvin. Then we just do the arithmetic and we end up with a density of 3.42 grams per liter. So this was fairly straightforward. We just had to do this clever algebraic manipulation to get the ideal gas law in terms of density.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.